Welcome to the Flutter PDF Viewer tutorial. In this video, discover how to fill out PDF forms seamlessly using the Syncfusion Flutter PDF Viewer. With this powerful tool, you can fill, edit, save, export, and import acro form fields in a PDF document. From text boxes and checkboxes to radio buttons, combo boxes, list boxes, and even signatures, Syncfusion Flutter PDF Viewer puts it all within easy reach. Next, I will demonstrate how to load and view a PDF with form fields in the PDF Viewer and interact with those form fields by editing, undoing, and redoing changes. Additionally, you will learn how to export and import form data, save the document, and open a fill document. First, I will open an existing Flutter application where I have already configured the Syncfusion Flutter PDF Viewer widget. If you want to know how to get started with the Syncfusion Flutter PDF Viewer, check out the video link in the card above or in the description below. Now let's see how to load a PDF with form fields using the Flutter PDF Viewer widget. I am going to load the PDF document directly from the asset. The application is already set up with the Syncfusion Flutter PDF Viewer widget, so the PDF document will display effortlessly from the asset bundle. Now I run the application. You will see the form document loaded in Flutter PDF Viewer on the mobile platform. Now I can edit and fill the form fields in the PDF document. Next, let's see how to perform undo and redo operations. First, I will create an undo history controller that includes undo and redo methods to handle those actions. Then, assign this controller to the undo controller property. And inside the app bar, define the undo and redo actions using a single child scroll view. Next, I create a value listenable builder that listens for changes in the undo redo controller. And set up a builder function that rebuilds whenever the controller updates, returning an icon button. Then define the onPressed event in the icon button widget. In the onPressed event, I check if canUndo is true. If the condition is satisfied, the undo operation is performed. If not, it returns null. Additionally, I set the icon to undo and add a tooltip. Now I am going to reuse this code for the redo button. So let me update the onPressed condition here to check can redo, performing the redo operation if true. Additionally, I update the icon and tooltip to redo to create space between the undo and redo buttons. Let me add a size box widget with a width of 10. Now I edit the name form field. When I click the undo and redo buttons, you will see the changes appear in the name field. Now let's move on to exporting and importing form data. First, I create an icon button for export operation. In that button, I set the icon and tooltip as export form data. Next, I define the onPressed event and create a list instance to store the exported form data as bytes. Then I call the PDF Viewer controller export form data method. To define the data format, import the PDF package and set the data format to XFDF. I set up space between buttons with another size box widget. Now I run the application. I filled the form fields in the PDF document to export the filled values. When I click the export button, it exports the form data and stores it as bytes. For importing, let me reuse most of this code, changing the icon and tooltip to import. In the onPressed event, I call import form data on the PDF viewer controller, passing in the exported bytes and format. After a hot reload, I clear out the form values, then click import to bring them back from the saved data. You will see the imported values displayed in the PDF. Finally, I will show you how to save and open the filled document. I reuse the same code for save operation. In this button, I change the icon and tooltip as save. In its onPressed event, I create a list to store the file as bytes, then call the save document method from the PDF viewer controller. To handle the save document across platforms, I add the path provider, web, and open file packages to pubspec YAML file. The web package handles the web platforms, while the path provider and open file are for other platforms. I create two Dart files, save helper and save helper web, to store and open the document based on the platform. In the save helper Dart file, I add the code to store the document and open the document from temporary storage. In the save helper web Dart file, I added the code to download the saved document on the web platform. Then call the save helper class and pass the byte array to save it as form document PDF. Now I run the application. Look here, I edit some form fields in the PDF document. When I click the save button, the document is saved to temporary storage, and the saved document is then displayed. Let me sum up this video. I have shown you how to load and view a PDF with form fields in the PDF viewer, interact with form fields by editing, undoing, and redoing changes, and export, import, save, and open the filled document. You can download the working example of this GitHub link in the description below. I have also shared a link to learn about obtaining a free license key to use our Essential Studio products if you are eligible for our community license. If you found this video useful, please like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching.